Touch of Class, written and directed by Michali Swainston-Harrison
and Thomas Harris, produced for The Fundamentals.
Episode 4, The Grand Opening.
Right, so the wine is sorted. Now, let's see. Do we have cheddar?
Check.
Brie?
Check.
Stilton?
Check.
Wensleydale?
Check.
Red Leicester?
Check.
And that is it.
Check.
What? No, that was not on the list.
Check.
Roger.
Check.
Roger, shut up.
Check. Oh, sorry. Yes.
Were you even listening to me?
Yes, of course.
Really? Well, what were we discussing then?
Well, you were listing off something like baby names.
Yes, baby names like yes. Red Leicester. Roger, how many times have I told you to pay attention to me when I am talking to you? Now we must check all the cheeses again.
Oh, don't worry, I got everything on the list. Aldi's pretty good with... Waitrose has a good cheese selection.
Aldi! Donna, I told you to go to Waitrose!
We cannot eat food from Aldi. Who do you think we are?
Yeah, well, I don't know if you've noticed, but we ain't got no Waitrose in these ends.
I do not care if you had to drive a whole night and day for one. We are supposed to have Waitrose. You are just lucky that we are pushed for time and have no money. Otherwise, you'd be fired, out on your ear, discharged, an early retirement, let go, and...
Really?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
I don't think so.
Neither do I.
Shut up, Roger!
Roger, I think you're right.
Thank you.
I also agree with the conversation we were having earlier.
So do I. What was it exactly?
You know, the pay rise you agreed to, or more to the point, actually paying me.
Oh, yes.
No, you didn't, because, Donna, we can't afford such expenses, unfortunately. And,
I know! I just like watching you two squirm.
Oh.
Now get over yourselves and deal with the wine and cheese from Aldi and start setting those chairs.
The wine is also from Aldi?
Don't worry, Jeremy. Look on the bright side. This will mean we fit in with the commoners, you know, cheap wine and all.
Yes, true. Like our canes with the duct tape. Yes,
yes,
very clever,
exactly.
Roger. Very clever. You know, Donna, I say we keep the wine and cheese from Aldi and fit in with our new neighbours, yes.
Yes, just don't tell Lorenzo.
Lorenzo? Who is Lorenzo?
No one. Just our local antique competitor, but no one to worry about at all. Yep,
antique competitor? Roger, why have you waited this long to tell me about this?
Well, you know, didn't want to make you nervous on your big day.
Nervous? Why would I be nervous? I'm never nervous. Why would I be? He's just healthy competition. It's not like he's already well-established and successful whilst we are just sat here with cheap wine and cheese. Oh, Roger, now I'm nervous.
Oh, Jeremy, there is no need to be nervous. I believe in you. Now, how about that speech you mentioned?
Yes, the speech, of course. Okay, yes. So.
Well, go on.
So, I was thinking of a speech, one which inspires the people, one that appeals to their hearts of hearts, lights a fire in their soul, and that fire is a passion for all things antique. We will become a success, and the family name will become the talk of the town. And it'll be one that strikes fear into our competitors and joy into all antique lovers. For we are the Anous brothers. We are success. And we are the...
And me.
What?
Don't forget me.
Of course. Donna, you are a valued member of the staff.
You mean the only staff member?
Well, yes. But if we had more, you'd be the top, I am sure of it.
Yes, if you'd stop interrupting me, yes.
What was that, Jeremy?
If she's to supply a toilet is what I said.
No, it wasn't. You said she should stop interrupting.
No, I didn't. Donna, I didn't mean that.
Shut up, Jeremy.
Okay, yes, sorry. Anyway, my speech. Let me tell you about my speech.
You do go on a bit.
Well, it's a It's a speech. Of course he would.
Yes, of course.
Maybe it's a sign for longing for attention.
I assure you, he gets all the attention he needs, Donna.
Well, then it must just be a deep-rooted feeling of inadequacy.
Surely not.
Oh, yes. For most public speakers, that's the reason, apparently. I read an article on it.
I cannot believe that. As Father used to say, an anus is like a hoose. Built up by bricks, and those are bricks of confidence.
Yes, on the outside, but the two of you are like tiny mice on the inside.
Donna, right, I find that an insult, and I assure you, you do not want to make an enemy of me. Just ask Lorenzo.
Maybe I should go work in his
shop. La, can't hear you.
Roger,
I was talking to you. Saying.
Explain it.
Donna and Lorenzo sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S. I-N-G.
When did I say that?
Oh, just now. Maybe I should go tell him.
Yeah, go on then.
Or maybe it was that sign man. You gazed into his eyes. Oh, his beautiful eyes.
What? No.
We have his number. Looks like I should make a phone call. Look, come on, I'm going to make a
Roger!
Phone call. I'm going.
People, I just wanted to... Guess I'll set the chairs then.
What a horrible noise!
Yes. Isn't it just? You know, Gertrude, I absolutely, positively detest such noise. Blooming, annoying, thank goodness we didn't take our horses.
Oh, quite. I doubt they would have been able to adjust to this horrible environment. The faces on some of these common folks is enough to frighten me, let alone our precious little ponies.
Yes.
I mean, did you see that wretch sitting in the porch of that shop? Filthy!
Yes, enough to make you bom-bom up your din-din.
Oh, quite. So where is Cousins Jeremy and Roger's shop, then?
I don't know. This is unfamiliar territory.
Indeed. One does not understand the terrain. I mean, who would write on the brick walls?
I believe they call it street graffiti.
Oh! My, you know how to make even this wretched hole seem semi-civilised.
Yes. I am, as you say, quite the... I don't know, something.
Why have we been invited?
I don't know, really. Probably because you still have the hots for them.
No, I don't. You do.
No, I don't. You do.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter, because I don't feel like either of them will be able to resist us now that their father is definitely out of the picture. How else will they make their money without us?
Yes, indeed. Mm. They'll have no choice but to surrender to our charm.
And our money.
Yes.
And Bertie, not a word to them of their mother.
Oh, of course. Mum's the word. Oh. You see what I did there?
Yes. Oh, excuse me, commoner.
Golf.
No. Oh, no. No. No! Oh, no, it's... Oh, no! No!
What? What is it?
It is them. Oh, it's the devils in skirts. Oh, why are they here?
Who? Those ladies?
Oh, no, they aren't just any ladies. They are our cousins.
And?
Oh, no! No!
Everything okay?
Not really. Jeremy's seen your cousins and ain't too pleased about it.
Oh, why are they here?
I invited them.
What?
I invited them.
Why?
Well, I thought you'd want some family here since Dad is gone and Mummy's all the way in Oxford.
What? No! Why would you do that? You know how I feel about them, Roger.
Yes, but we need the numbers. No. I didn't think it'd be too much of a problem.
Oh, anything but them. It'll be a whole night of judgment and venom. They'll know that the wine is from Aldi.
Well, as long as neither of us get drunk and almost agree to marry them again.
Shut up!
You what?
It was this party, right?
No, okay, no, shut up. Shut up, the both of you. I would... No, shut up. Okay, the both of them will smell out any secrets and any weaknesses. We must stay strong as united, a front, united. I will turn them away. Just stand behind me. I will turn them away.
Hello!
Ah, hello, dear cousins, Gertie and Bertie. How are you?
Oh, hello, JJ and Roomy Room.
Oh, Jesus.
Servant girl, take my coat.
I'm not a servant girl.
Don't chat back, just follow our orders.
Excuse me.
You heard?
Yes, yes, you heard right.
I suggest you obey.
Before G and B sue your pretty little face.
For everything you own. Isn't that right, boys?
Yes. Yes, Donna?
Yes, you must listen to us. We are, after all, the elite.
Her name's Donna. Brilliant!
What's wrong with that?
Oh, nothing.
Go and get us some tea, Donna.
Yes, Donna. Go make us some tea.
Yes, Donna.
Shut up. Oh.
Yes, go get the tea, Donna.
Shut up!
So, girls, how was the trip?
Absolutely horrendous.
Yes, yes, so many poor people.
Oh, that's nice to hear that you're compassionate for them, calling them poor people.
No, I meant they're poor. Yuck.
Oh.
I tell you, if I ran the country, I would not hesitate.
Well said, Bertie, but you do remember what our therapist said.
Yes, yes. Keep a lid on it, and when you want to shout, write it down so others don't get down.
Since when did you need a therapist?
Since you drove one servant girl to the brink of murder.
Not my fault that the lower class can't take a joke.
Well, at least this opening will be full of well-respected members of society.
Oh, no.
I've only seen that one guy that like talked to us the other day.
Yeah.
That's our first.
Yeah. I feel
that. It feels like we're outside of the like Parliament building.
I was about to say, I feel like I'm eating. You know,
it is, man. I mean, like they talk about the whole country and that, and get paid to do it.
Yeah. I wish I was a politician.
Why?
Yeah.
Because I want to make change, Tim. Do you want to make change?
Man, I don't need to make no change.
Hey, bro, I want to make change. I want to make peace, you know, like...
What on earth are we doing here? It has only been half an hour and I am already feeling nauseous at the sight of some of these people.
Gertie, I think my temper is almost at boiling point. These ruffians are starting to trigger the worst in me.
Try and hold it together. There are too many of them at the moment. Maybe we should get Daddy to buy the land around here so as to vacate them out of the area.
Yes, that is a brilliant idea. I need cake.
Have you boys ever seen Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone?
Yeah, I've seen that movie. That's my favourite movie.
Yeah. Do you remember the bit in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone where he goes to the bank and finds all his dead parents' money?
Yeah, bro.
You've done it.
Well, it's less like that and more I just see everything as free real estate, you know?
How is everything going?
It's going well. I mean, the wine is almost gone and the cheese has been eaten and the youths are sitting on the arms of the chairs instead of the seats of the chairs. But, look, I managed to find a record player.
Oh, I noticed. Very impressive. Where did you find that?
Well, don't tell Donna, but I borrowed the credit card.
Oh, Roger! very good. Anyway, when shall I speak?
Soon.
Oh, Donna, when did you get here?
We were definitely not talking about stealing the credit card and buying a record player.
Shut up, Roger. Shut up.
Sorry.
My speech. I've worked on this all day.
Go get them, brother.
Are Gertie and Bertie looking at us?
Wow, Bertie is.
But Gertie seems to be rather transfixed by our grandfather clock.
Donna, give them some wine to Gertie and Bertie, will you?
Of course.
I've never seen a posh man in Velcros. It's like they don't sell him at Burton Menswear, do they?
No, I know.
No, that's some like top shot.
Oh, excuse me. Do you work here?
Yes, I do.
Brilliant. I was invited by one of those sharp-looking lads over in there.
Oh, wow. Well, pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, all right. Anyway, I had a question.
Of course.
Those windows, are they double glazed?
I'm not sure.
I was just wondering, because I saw that you had the right-handed ventilation child safety locks on the windows, which was very interesting, actually. They are good locks.
Okay.
Thanks. Anyway, also, how much was the grandfather clock worth?
If you managed to fix it, maybe $2,000? Why? You thinking of purchasing it?
Oh, no, not at all.
Shut up, Tim.
Yeah, whatever.
Shut up.
I like Dutch cheese, innit?
Oh, gosh, this opening is a bit of a rough evening. When will someone of good esteem and decorum arrive?
I don't know. I brought some cake if you want any.
No, I'm strictly keeping to my no-fat diet, you know that.
Of course. Sorry.
Grüezi, ladies.
Oh, hello. The class has arrived.
Oh, hello.
Lorenzo Amstutz at your service. I am trying to find the Anus brothers. Have you seen them?
Well, we are their cousins.
Really? How lovely.
A lot more polished than they are, however.
Name's Bertrude.
And Gertrude.
The pleasure is mine, ladies.
Finally, a real man, a real gentleman.
Some wine, my ladies.
Go away.
Jesus Christ.
La 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 la.
Watch your tongue in the presence of real ladies.
Look, I have had enough of you poshies. The one place in London where you'd think all you'd have to deal with is rowdy teens, middle-aged men, and drunk footy fanatics and some homeless beggars. But no, it's full of bigoted, stupid, narcissistic, pernickety toffs. You can't do anything for themselves. I have worked hard to get where I am now. I didn't grow up suckling on some fancy silver spoon and not having to do a single day's work with all your privilege. You can't even treat me, a normal woman, with more respect than you give a stray dog. It's ridiculous and I am sick of it. I've had enough.
Oh, good one, Donna. Good. Very, very funny. Here, ladies and youths, we have our assistant, Donna, displaying her love for the dramatics in life, hoping one day to be on EastEnders.
No, I am not. Don't you start. I've had it up to here with you.
She's very good, always in character. anyway, moving on. Good evening, my name is Jeremy Anus, and, my name is Jeremy Anus, and...
Anus!
Oh, how lovely that ghastly pub fellow dropped by. Anyway, my name is Jeremy Anus. Why are they laughing?
I have no idea. But you're doing well, brother.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jeremy Anus. And this is my brother, Roger. Together, we want to welcome you here tonight to our grand opening. We have the ceremonial red band and the golden scissors to cut it. And I want to welcome all of you, friends, neighbours, countrymen of Gibson Avenue.
Lorenzo, you rapscallion. He's here.
Do you ladies maybe want to accompany me to my antique shop down the road? Where we have many items of great value and importance to society. And of course, it is away from this ghastly atmosphere.
Oh yes, that would be lovely.
Gertie?
What, darling?
Haven't we seen that clock before?
Maybe. Oh, it is quite nice.
Which one?
The one... that's in the store.
Oh, wow, that's a lovely clock.
So, where is your shop?
Sorry, yes, down the street, I shall walk you both, but I just need to quickly talk to someone. I'll be right back.
Oh, what a lovely man.
Yes, yes, lovely. He did make me spit out my cake, though.
Oh, be quiet.
Sammy!
Lorenzo!
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Now, how's it going?
It is going very, very well.
So, yeah, like, I went to Liz's here, and she was all like, yeah, you're my hero, and that, and like, I love you.
Love? Bruv, nah. Wait, what did you say?
Well, I was like, you know, I love you too.
What? Nah, you just kidding, bro.
Yeah, yeah, of course. You're like, I mean, I was actually like, I don't care, girl. You're just my woman.
Hey, my guy, my guy. So after, you want to go to that party and find another Liz, yeah?
Nah, I'm gonna go home.
I thought your parents had left, though.
Well, I'll just go walk around, like, Applefrost Lane or something.
But anyway, I thought that's where Liz lives.
Wine. That is what we need, boys. Sorry, we need more wine.
City.
Jeremy.
Don't worry, Jeremy. I like everyone else in this country.
So, as I have said
before, like our forefathers, we will build something worth stealing. What? No, oh, no, wait, wait, no. Everyone, I didn't mean that. I meant a fire of London, and, oh my goodness, who is that man with Bertie and Gertie?
He's the competitor I was telling you about.
Get on with it. Bring out the antiques, innit?
What, bruv?
I mean, we want more wine.
Yeah! Innit?
Blah, 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 blah. Fire, success, London. Buy our lovely old antique stuff. And finally, the snip.
Oh, blow this. Now, Tim, grab the last bottle of wine and let's bounce.
Oi, Tim. Get your eyes off that cock, innit?
Bro, you can see that it's a clock. Do not start this again, man. It's a clock. Do you know what a clock is? Can you tell the time?
Where were we, ladies?
Off to your place.
Curse the charm of the Swiss. A Touch of Class. Written and directed by Michali Swainston-Harrison and Thomas Harris.
Jeremy, played by Thomas Harris.
Roger, played by Michali Swainston-Harrison.
Donna, played by Sean McLaughlin.
Gertrude, played by Mia Angel Jackson.
Bertrude, played by Jazz Harbour.
Timmy, played by Henry Barker.
Jimmy, with a G, played by Alfie Ford.
Billy, played by Taylor Maguire.
Lorenzo, read by Nicholas Koch.
Sammy, played by Alfie Ford.
Football Fan, played by Josh Shortland.